Hey guys, Driven to Conquer here. This is going to be kind of a quick little short recap of my first week in Project Diablo 2 Season 5. Yeah, nothing really special on this one. We're going to show some drops, a couple slams, the highlights, and I guess low points of this first week. But the first week's been great. We're doing a soft core whirlwind barb. We started as Frenzy, and you know, their gear's going to be at the end of the video. Timestamps will be available as well if you just want to skip around to that. But we're going to get into the first drops going in here right now. First big drop, just doing Pit mostly as Aspired Helm. Pit was really good to us for the most part. That's our best part to farm before we could finish Bale. So we got a Veil of Steel there coming out of Pit. And our MF is maybe like 90, less than 100. So not bad. We go ahead and slam this Veil of Steel because I'm a fucking idiot. And it's gone. Moving on. No, Pit, not that great of a drop here. Nothing special, a Templar Coat, which we know this to be Guardian Angel. Decent rolls on that one. Moving on, we're farming Travancore a lot. We find my favorite helm, probably, in the game. One of them, at least. We find a Grim Helm, doing some Trav. We know the Grim Helm to be none other than Vamp Gaze. Decent rolls, 15, 11, actually kind of shitty on that one. Good Merc Helm. Really, really good Merc. Oh, yeah, we don't slam it. So this is our first notable rune. Doing some Chaos Sank. Find an Ist rune. Not bad. I'm not showing, like, ohms and, you know, things like that. And so we go back. We hork a Grim Shield at Travancore again. Again, I was just doing random runs. You know, I don't even think I killed Bale at this point. Lithless Wall, plus one skill. God damn it. Dog shit. But it's okay. Early season, still might be able to sell that. Doing some more Travancore. Blasting. Find a unique amulet. Spinning. Picky up. And what amulet do we have? Amara's. Very nice. Very, very nice. So yeah, Trav and Pit were really good to me. Us. Or me, whatever, this first week. Did some Chaos Sank. Chaos Sank was pretty good. Here's another one. We find a Winged Helm after killing Diablo. Not the craziest helm, but very tried and true standard one. G-Face, 35, Crushing Blow, 15 Deadly Strike. Pretty nice. I'm rocking an Aerith's Face on this one. I traded a Wing Helm for it, a Valk Helm. Find one of my favorite belts in this game, Demonhide Sash. I think this is a really, really good belt, whether for yourself or a mercenary, if you don't have Redungos or something, or Drax or whatever. So we find a String of Ears, 12-12. So I have another pair there. I think I corrupt this one and break it. I don't think I have the footage of this one, though. But, yep, great belt. Love String of Ears. So at this point, we finally killed Bale, finally beat Hell, and we found a Homunculus, which I think is still available for trade. So that was just nice to find something. First kill of Bale. Actually dropped something. Good for us. We haven't really farmed much Bale at this point. Moving on, another Chaos run. We find Tomic Mask. Totomic, whatever. We know this one to be Jalal's. But it's a 2-2 with kind of not the best stats, but at least the plus 2 on the shape-shifting skills. I don't think I've listed this one yet to sell, but be good for any druid doing shapeshifting. We find a puzzle piece. Yeah, I was surprised to see this one. This is a new item for season 5. Different than the puzzle boxes, which are still around. But puzzle pieces cannot be used on unique or set items, but they can't. They're good for corrupting, putting in sockets for crafted or rare items that you might be using. Moving back to Trav, we find a unique ring drop. Pick it up. And what do we have? SOJ. Very surprised to see this. 34 mana, 18 maximum mana. Pretty decent. I have not listed this or slammed it because I'm a coward. More Trav. We find a Hunter's Gaze. Guys, whatever. It's a 2 to summoning, 1 to druid skills. That's unfortunate that we didn't get the 2 to druid skills. Another Trav. We find Bramble Mitts, which we always know those to be a good pair of Laying of Hands. Not the best rolls on it, but hey, decent enough. probably use that once I get enough strength to use my other weapon. So then we move in and start doing maps. And maps were kind of dry for a little bit, but this one, killing the map boss, finally found a Stone Crushers. Oops, spoiler alert. I guess I don't want to identify it. But yeah, Stone Crushers. This got nerfed a little bit. We got low rolls on that. Unfortunately, we're going to try to slam this just for shits and giggles. See what we get. And we get shits and giggles. We slammed 10 faster cast rate and minus or a 5% fire skill damage. I don't know. Maybe we can use that for like a holy fire sealer or something. I don't know. Doing more maps. We find a Shaco's though. Not pretty bad. Not too bad for the first week. I'm full of garbage, so I can't pick it up. What a noob. But we get that Shaco's. We're going to see what roll we got on it. Got a 46 MF roll out of 50. Not bad. Not bad. I'm surprised this hasn't sold yet. And, you know, maybe I'll keep this in the Mars if I want to do a summoner. Going on, doing that same map, we find a Larzix puzzle piece. Again, another one. These aren't as rare as puzzle boxes, but if you're doing, like, crafting, this is awesome. I don't even really know what these go for. Still do another Horizons map. We get a double drop. We get a pure Demonic Essence and another Grim Shield, another Lidless. Hopefully it's not as garbage as the other one, and it's even worse. Plus one, plus four to mana after kill. Lame. Same map, we find a Bone Visage, Trang's Helm. Awesome. I go ahead and slam this one just for some shits and gigs, and we get a two open socket. Not bad. Same map, we get another set helm. We get a Grim Helm. We know this to be Natalia's totem. Shitty rolls, unfortunately. Continuing on with the same Horizons map, we find another set item. This time, it's Mavina's Matron Bow, the Grand Matron Bow, Mavina's caster. And I think I go ahead and slam this one. Pretty sure, yep. Slam it. We kept it, and we got ED and ignores target's defense. And I don't know if that's really what you want on for a Mavina's. You probably want open socket since you're probably doing elementals, but anyway. This is the big drop. Last one, got this the other night. We got Big Daddy Burr in one of the new maps. Love it. So we got an Ist, the lowest tier of the high rune, and then we got a Burr for the highest tier. Very excellent. I'm very happy to see this, so we'll end the video on that high note. And if you want to stick around, I'll show you the gear after this. But we were very happy to find a Burr. Not too sure if I'm going to use it to buy stuff or maybe make another character. Anyway, so if you stuck around this long, you want to check out the gear, we'll just go through it real quick. It's changed a little bit throughout that video. In the beginning, I was using stuff like a Chance Guard and Lionheart and some Crafted Maul. And then a Tarn Helm and stuff. And then as I progressed, I was able to swap out some of those pieces. So this is kind of where we're sitting now. Before I was pretty much using a Lionheart through that whole video. As of last night, I was able to make a Fortitude. I found a low in Travancore, which was awesome. So we got our Fortitude going on now. Moving over, we have Windhammer. We have to use the IK gloves in order to get the strength in order to use this. Area's Face. I traded a Valkwing for this. I couldn't find the video of the Valkwing dropping, but I'm pretty sure it was a Valkwing that someone traded me an Area's Face for, so that was gratefully accepted. We have Seraph's Hymn, just a good plus two all skills. This is until I find a High Lords or something like that, but that damage to demons and damage to undead and attack rating isn't too bad. Moving over, we got some Goblin Toe. I found a couple of pairs of those, nothing special. And then we have our Raven Frost for our Cannot Be Frozen. There's our String of Ears. I'm pretty sure I bricked one of the other ones. Again, couldn't find the video of that, but still rocking that. And then we just have Mandel Heal just for some mana stolen per hit. Really, really need that for this build. And then our, like I said, our IK gloves. Nothing special. I've only respec'd once, and that was coming from Frenzy. I went Frenzy through Normal and Nightmare really easy, and then I just found that Frenzy Hell was kind of... I just wasn't geared up enough for it. It didn't feel well, so I figured that I could just, you know, either go into Double Throw or Whirlwind. Since I'm not playing Hardcore, might as well just go Whirlwind, and it's been doing just fine. And over on our Merc, nothing really special. IK Maul, just for some big damage for him. We put our Chance Guards over there, swapped him out because he was using the IK Gloves before. Lionheart went over there. He's using our Grim Helm. Then you just IK belt and then the extra goblin toe. Really nothing special. If you want to look at the stats, what I have, again, I've only respect one, so I have a lot of wasted stat points. We'll just start at the combat skills. Pretty much go right down, max out whirlwind. We're at 27 whirlwind on that one. No synergies for whirlwind at this time. Combat masteries, max out general mastery. If you're using like a Reaper's Toll, then you're going to do pole armor and spears. Pretty sure. Yeah. Pretty sure the scythe falls under polearm. Combat reflexes, put a couple points into speed, put a couple more points in iron skin just for that DR, which is really, really nice. And then a couple more points into natural resistances just to buff those up. Over to Warcry, 1-1 battle orders. I think I put one or two, I think maybe one, but we max out battle command so we can get that increased plus three skills, which bumps up our damage a whole bunch. Battlecry got nerfed thing. I put a few points into it. It's okay. That's another reason why Frenzy didn't feel really well, because you had to use Battlecry a little bit more. And since my faster cast rate wasn't up, it was opening me up to getting sent into hit recovery when I try to cast this while frenzying. And it just didn't feel well. But this is still used, you know. And then we have Grim Ward, which I'm putting the remaining points into this at this point. Grim Ward's great. Lots of damage. It really, really beefs up your damage a lot if you can incorporate throwing that every now and again into your thing. And then, of course, we have our find item, which this gets to over 10 when we, you know, battle command it up. And then synergies if you want to do that. So, yeah, pretty simple. Stats are all messed up. Just because I haven't reached spec again. We're only at level 88, doing things pretty casually. Bunch into strength. I got to balance this out again. I'll probably respec again here at some point so I can utilize my stat points a little bit better. But other than that, yeah, it's a pretty basic whirlwind build. Nothing that special other than the Ariat's face and the fortitude. Really is probably the most expensive pieces on this, and it's got a lot of room for improvement. And as you saw, we're crushing maps and stuff. So anyway, if you guys stuck around this far in the video, appreciate it. I'm going to start streaming on Twitch here, probably starting this week. Got a late start, but I've just been doing that first week pretty casually, and it's been pretty good. So anyway, thanks again for checking it out. And if you don't know about Project Diablo 2, there'll be links in the description. Send you to the site. Great mod, probably the best, in my opinion, the best mod for Diablo 2. All you need is a legit copy of Diablo 2 and Lord of Destruction expansion, and you're able to free to play this amazing mod. Anyway, guys, thanks for coming by, checking out, and there'll be some more content coming up here later.